Now at the junction D, how many currents are there? I2, IG, I4. Now I2 is there, IG is there. The algebraic sum of these three currents is equals to 0. I2 is towards the junction D, positive. IG is towards the junction D, that is positive. That is I4 is away from the junction D, negative. Therefore, now Kirchhoff first law is applied, Kirchhoff second law is applied. Next, Kirchhoff second law. Kirchhoff first law is applied at the two junctions. Next, Kirchhoff second law. Kirchhoff second law is applied. Kirchhoff second law is applied. Right, Kirchhoff, while applying the Kirchhoff second law, right, at every branch, at every resistance, higher potential point, lower potential point. Now current is traveling like this. This is the higher potential point, this is the lower potential point. As the current is traveling from higher potential to lower potential, here the current is traveling like this. Therefore, this is the higher potential point, that is lower potential point. Now current is traveling like this. This is the higher potential point and this is the lower potential point. As the current is traveling like this, this is the higher potential point. Now this is the lower potential point. Now here the current is traveling like this. This is the higher potential point. Now this is the lower potential point. Now that is Kirchhoff's second law is applied for any loop. Kirchhoff's second law is applied for any loop. Now that is I will take right A, B, D, A. Therefore A, B, D, A loop. Right, for this loop. Right, A, B, D, A. A to B, B to D, D to A. Right, what is the direction? A to B, B to A, D to A. This is called, what to say, arbitrary direction. Now this is also known as loop direction. Choose the loop first. What is the name of the loop? A, B, D, A loop. Right, in that loop, how many resistances are there? Right, how many resistances? P, G, R. How many currents are there? I1, IG, R. What is the potential difference? Current multiplied by resistance, I1P. What is the potential difference? Current multiplied by resistance, IG into G. What is the potential difference? Current multiplied by resistance, I2 into R. Now, here there is no cells in the circuit. Whatever I take the loop, that is, there is no, what to say, cell. Therefore, here current multiplied by the resistance, that is I1 into P. Next, here current multiplied by resistance, that is IG into G. Right, here what is the current multiplied by resistance, that is I2 into R. The algebraic sum of potential differences is equals to 0. Now travel along the loop. Right, if you are traveling along the arbitrary direction, right, that is potential drop is there negative, potential rise is there positive. Right, A, B, D, A. Now here A to B, higher potential to lower potential. Higher potential to lower potential, that is called potential drop. Potential drop is that equals to minus. Next one. Therefore here is also, right, B to D, B to D. That is, while traveling from B to D, higher potential to lower potential. Again, higher potential to lower potential drop. Therefore, this is also negative. Next one, continue. Lower to higher. Higher to lower, and lower to higher. Lower to higher means there is a rise in potential, that is called plus. Therefore, this is called, what to say, third equation. Next loop this kunda. Now let us consider next loop. B, C, D, B. That is B, C, D, B loop. Now let us consider B, C, D, B loop. What is the name of the loop? B, C, D, B is the loop. Right? In this loop, current resistance. Current I4, resistance S. Current IG and the resistance G. In this loop, how many resistances are there? Q, S, G. How many currents are there? I3, I4, IG. What is the potential? What are the potential differences? I3 into Q. Here the potential difference, I4 into S. Here the potential difference, IG into G. Now here in this case, that is I3 into Q. Right, next, that is I4 into S. Next, that is what to say, IG into G is equals to 0. The algebraic sum of potential differences is equals to 0. Along the BCDB loop, I want to travel BCDB like this. Right, here along this one, higher potential to lower potential. Higher potential to lower potential drop is there. Therefore, this is the negative. Next, continue. That is lower potential to higher potential. Continue. Lower potential to higher potential. Rise is there. Potential rise is taken as positive. Next, D to B. As we are traveling from D to B, lower to higher. Lower to higher is also taken as rise. Therefore, this is also taken as positive. Therefore, this is the fourth equation. By applying the first law, two equations are there. By applying the second law, again two equations are there. In order to calculate the balancing condition, in order to balance that Wheatstone bridge, let us consider. Let IG is equals to 0. That means through the galvanometer there is no current. Through the galvanometer no current means I1 is there. No current is passing through that is IG. Total current is passing through I3. Here no current is towards the junction D. Therefore IT is simply as a I4. Therefore that is what is the current passing through the galvanometer? That is IG is 0. Now as the current is 0, there is no current. There is no current means there is no potential. There is no potential means there is no potential difference. As there is no potential difference, therefore whatever the potential at B, the same potential at the D. Therefore B and D are at same potential. Same potential. Therefore, let the current passing through the galvanometer is 0. Whenever the current passing through the galvanometer is 0, B and D are at the same potential. Now, IG is equals to 0 from the first equation. What is our first equation? I1 minus IG minus 0 minus I3 is equals to 0. That implies that is I1 is equals to I3. This is called fifth equation. Now from the second equation I2 right plus IG is equals to 0 minus I4 is equals to 0. That implies I2 is equals to I4. That is called sixth equation. Now from the third equation, that is minus I1P, minus IG into G, IG is equals to 0, 0 into G, 0, minus 0, right, plus that is I2 into R is equals to 0. Therefore, this may be implied as a I1P is equals to I2, that is R. Therefore, this is called seventh equation. Now, what is the fourth equation here? From the fourth equation, that is minus I3Q, right, plus I4S, plus, that is IG is equals to 0, 0 into G, 0, that equals to 0, right, that implies I3Q is equals to I4S. This is called what to say, eighth equation. Right, from 7 and 8, right? Now, that is I1P by, that is I3Q on dividing both, I2, that is R by, what do you say, I4 into S. Therefore, 7 and 8 are divided. Therefore, I1P by I3Q, I2R by I4S. Therefore, here I1P by I3 is equals to here, see I3 is equals to I1. Therefore, I3 is equals to I1, that is Q is equals to, that is next I2 into R, I4 is equals to I2 into S. Therefore, I1 gets cancelled, I2 gets cancelled, P by Q is equals to R by S. P by Q is equals to R by S. Therefore, this is called balancing condition of Wheatstone bridge. This is called balancing condition of Wheatstone bridge. Now, let us consider. For example, now this is, there are four resistances, right? Therefore, there is another resistance. This is called, what to say, similar to the A and B. Now this is called 10 ohm, this is called 20 ohm, this is called, what to say, 40 ohm, this is called, what to say, 80 ohm, now this is called 50 ohm. Now here in this case, calculate the effective resistance means this circuit is similar to the Wheatstone bridge circuit. Now, this is called, right, P by Q is equals to R by S. Right, P by Q is equals to R by S. This is called, what to say, P. This is called, what to say, Q. Right, this is called, what to say, R. Now, this is, what to say, S. Right, now P by Q is equals to R by S. This is called galvanometer resistance. Therefore, P by Q is equals to, what to say, R by S. What is the P value? 10. What is the Q value? 20. Therefore, what is the R value? 40. What is the S value? 80. Therefore, 1 by 2 is equal to, what to say, 1 by 2. Hence, bridge is balanced. P by Q is equal to R by S. Then the bridge is said to be balanced. Right? Whenever it is in a balanced condition, what is the current passing through the galvanometer? Galvanometer current is zero. Now, in the place of galvanometer, what is there? 50 ohm is there. Whenever there is no current, potential drop is nothing. As the potential drop is nothing, means you want to delete this one. As a result, what is the result? This equation may be turned as like this. Now, this is called 10. Now, this is the 20. Now this is 40. Now this is 80. Now as the bridge is balanced, then the galvanometer is said to be removed. Why? Because galvanometer current is zero, potential drop is zero. Now the equation will become as a, right, these two are under series. The series resistances are added. Therefore, this is called 30 ohm. This is called, what to say, right, 10 plus 20, that is 30 ohm, because in series 40 plus 80, that equals to 120 ohm. These two are under parallel. Under parallel, Rp is equals to R1 into R2 by R1 plus R2. That is 30 into 120 by, that is 30 plus 120. That equals to 30 into 120 by, that is 150. That is 5 4 Therefore, effective resistance is equals to, what to say, 24. Therefore, in the circuit, if it is balanced, P by Q is equals to R by S, then the effective resistance of the circuit is said to be 24 ohm.